Welcome to Narcissus No More, where we're here to help educate you about narcissistic abuse because your feelings do matter. Hi, and welcome to another podcast of Narcissus No More with your host, Dr. and Evangelist, K.L. Rich. Thanks for tuning in today. Today is Wednesday. Yes, it is Wednesday, September the 27th of 2023. I pray that you've had a blessed, stress-free, narcissistic-free, abuse-free week so far, and that the remainder of this week will continue to be so as well. But if not, we're going to be talking about a few things today. Again, my name is Dr. K.L. Rich with Narcabuse No More, where we're here to help you admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Yes, they do. But before we go on with today's podcast, I'd like to invite you to visit us on our website at www.narcabusenomore.org. Again, that website address is www.narcabusenomore.org. And on our website, you'll find valuable information regarding relationships, and you can listen to these podcasts. If you have missed any of them, you can go directly to our website and listen to us from there. Just to let you know, we're on every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 9 a.m. Central, and that is on SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Spreaker, Google Play, iTunes, CastBox, and Deezer. We're also on Amazon Audible, Rumble, Brighteon, and The Tube. That's why we're on YouTube. So you have a variety of different platforms that you can listen to us from. But if all else fails, all you have to do is go directly to our website at www.narcabusenomore.org. Also, just to let you know, the beginning of the year, we will have a new podcast in addition to this one. And this will be Veterans in Christ. Veterans in Christ. And that's going to be dealing with a lot of different issues that veterans have as it pertains to spirituality. We're also going to be talking about veteran benefits, veteran claims, CNP exams, PTSD, mental health issues, depression, suicide prevention. We're also going to be talking about things that relates to if there's ever a draft. It's not impossible. So if there's ever a draft, what you need to know for you and your family, also transitioning from active duty. So if you are in the service right now, you're going to be getting out, and what to expect getting back into the civilian things, aspect of society. Also, we're going to be talking about veteran news, military news, and we're going to be having a lot of different things that we will be discussing. That will be Veterans in Christ aired in January, and I will keep you updated for us. The time, the time is going to be 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 4 p.m. Central, or you can listen at the time of your choice. We're going to have a website that's just for the Veterans in Christ, and we will have our same platforms as we do on this particular podcast. So we're going to be on iHeartRadio, Spotify, Spreaker, Google Play, iTunes, CastBox, and Deezer, and all the other platforms that we are on as it pertains to this podcast and the one that's going to be coming. All right, so what are we talking about today? We are talking about reasons people abuse. We're going to go through 13 reasons people abuse. As always, I'd love to give you a valuable website where you can get this information, and that is psychcentral.com, psychcentral.com, and we're talking about reasons people abuse. Now, there are many reasons why people are abused, and then those that are trying to understand why their abuser did the abuse to them. There are many different forms of abuse. When we talk about that on this podcast, when it comes to emotional, physical, sexual, spiritual, verbal, emotional abuse, financial abuse. So there's different types of abuse. Not all abuse come in the same form, but it can have the same traumatizing effects. A physical one, however, can put you in the grave, all right? So we definitely don't want anyone to be going through any type of abuse. else. But when you realize that that person has abused you, then sometimes people battle with why, with the why. Why did this person abuse me? One thing we want to make sure that we are clear about is just because we know and understand the reasons why does not excuse, come on now, it does not excuse anyone for the abuse that they've done to someone else. Just because you may have a reason that may have led you to abuse does not justify nor give you the okay to abuse. For example, I'm going to use the court system. You may be poor. Okay. You may have come from a poor background. Your family may not have had enough, a lot of money. So you struggled. All right. But when you become an adult, all right, when you become an adult, it doesn't mean that you have the okay to go rob a bank just because, oh, I have a poor background. Oh, my parents were poor. I couldn't afford shoes. I had holes in my clothes. That's all good and dandy. We understand that, you know, it could have taken a toll on you. However, it does not give you the right to go rob a bank. It does not give you the right to take anybody captive, or you in the bank and, you know, you hold it up like what, Jesse James or somebody, and to be able to abuse others because of what happened to you. That is never okay. So we're going to shed some light on why people abuse, but it does not give them the right to abuse. This is for those that are maybe gone through abuse and you're trying to understand, well, why did they do this to me? So we're going to give you some reasons as to why they may have done it, but it does not give them the okay, nor is this for to encourage you to stay in an abusive situation. No one has the right to abuse anyone else. Let me repeat that. No one has the right to abuse anyone else, regardless of the reasoning behind it. It is a choice. When you decide you're going to abuse someone, you are making a choice to say, I'm going to do X, Y, and Z. But that does not give you the okay to do it. So number one, one of the reasons that people abuse is that they may have a disorder. They may have a disorder. Some people have antisocial personality disorder. They might be a psychopath, a sociopath. They might be sadistic. However, these type of people may get pleasure from seeing others in pain. They get pleasure from doing things, nasty things to others. Let me use the example of those who remember the series from long ago, Little House on the Prairie, with Laura and Nellie and even her little brother. So Nellie in Little House on the Prairie, she was a very spoiled, rotten child. Okay, she did all kind of nasty little things to hurt people until she finally met her match with her husband, and this person did not take any stuff off of Nellie, and Nellie finally grew up and changed her ways. So some people are just nasty for the sake of nastiness, or they may have some kind of antisocial personality disorder that causes them to go against the grain, and so they abuse people for the simple pleasure of it. They could be a psychopath, they could be a sociopath. Everyone that's a psychopath or sociopath doesn't always kill people. Some of these little Chuckies here, okay, they started off as children killing animals and things, and they got a rise out of just being nasty. Have you seen the bully that's on the school playground? It's not that someone did something to them, but they just want to be nasty for the sake of being nasty, or hurting someone else, or bullying someone else. So some of this is, it could be some type of personality disorder. However, it doesn't give them the excuse to do it. If they know that they're doing things, unless they just have no conscience, don't absolutely understand right from wrong, that it does not give them an excuse to abuse others. Nor do you have to stay in an abusive situation just because someone has a personality disorder that causes you pain. Number two, they may have been abused themselves. Some abusers act out their dysfunction onto others because they had experienced abuse themselves. For example, you may have a pedophile who abused children, and it's because it may go back to him being abused as a child. However, he is making, or she is making, a conscious choice to abuse someone else instead of getting help. So the type of behavior is identical to what matched their early childhood experiences. It does not, however, give them the right to do so, because they have to make a choice to say that, you know what, even though this was done to me, does not mean that I'm going to do it to someone else. It's just like, I'm going to use an example of a deadbeat father. You may have many men that are deadbeat fathers because their fathers were deadbeats, but does that give them the excuse to say, well, you know what, I'm not going to take care of my child because my father didn't take care of me? No, you should want to do better than what your parent did with you. So therefore, you're making a choice to say that I'm going to be abusive. You're making a choice to say I'm going to be neglectful. You're making a choice to say that, you know what, I'm going to be unempathetic, and I'm going to do all these nasty things to another human being. Another part of them being abused, as we just mentioned before, is that the abuse was done to them, but the victim, however, in the case of the victim, it is the opposite. So, for example, a boy may have been abused by a man and then grow up to abuse girls, or whatever the case may be, or vice versa. This is never okay. This is never okay for you to do something just because it was done to you. One thing is that you should remember how you felt when it was done to you, so therefore you don't want to do it to someone else. If you were abused as a child, and it would be better for you not to have children if you think that you're going to abuse your children, just to keep from doing that to someone else because you remember what was done to you. Number four, they watch something happen. You have those that may be abusive because they watched it as a child. They may have been exposed to it as a child where it was glorified. We have a lot of different videos that glorify violence, okay, whether you watch MTV or whatever, BET or whatever case may be, TV shows, video games, songs that glorify violence. It is not okay to verbally attack someone by calling them names, belittling them, demeaning them. For example, you have a lot of songs that call women B's and H's and everything. I'm not neither one, but you have this type of mentality that is going on in people's minds. And so therefore they think that just because this person wrote this song, that this is how people are, or it's okay to address someone as such when they are, it is not okay. All right, we're going to take a quick break and we'll be back in just a moment.
This beautiful love that we now the day.
Don't Say Goodbye. And that is, I forgot who wrote that song. That's from way back in the day. But anyway, but sometimes you do have to say goodbye to people, so disregard some of that, some of those lyrics. Okay, so we're talking about 13 reasons why people abuse. Number five, they have anger issues. They have anger issues. When you are dealing with someone who is abusive, a lot of times they have uncontrolled rage. They are like the Incredible Hulk. If you remember the series from back in the 70s or even the newer renditions they've made, they have rage. And as the Hulk will say, you wouldn't like me when I'm angry. So they go into these fits of rage, and it produces them, for its abusive behavior. Anything can spark these individuals. We often talk about narcissistic rage, where it comes, you just know, you don't know what bag they're going to come out of on any given day. So it's harder to control the abuse. So they may have anger issues, and it can stem back from childhood or whatever the case may be. At the same time, it does not give them the right or the excuse to abuse someone else. And before we go on with today's podcast, I want to give you the information to the National Domestic Violence Hotline. And that is www.thehotline.org. www.thehotline.org. That is the National Domestic Violence Hotline. I believe you can also read the information in Spanish if you are a Spanish speaker. You could call 1-800-799-SAFE. That's 1-800-799-7233. TTY callers, 1-800-787-3224. You can also chat with them live by texting the word START to 88788. Again, text the word START to 88788. You are not alone. And if you need help getting out of a situation domestic wise, these are advocates who can help you to tell you what you may need to do in order to get you out of that situation safely as possible. They're available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and they try not to have you holding longer than 15 minutes. So please get the help that you need. Number six. Another reason why abusers sometimes abuse is they grew up with an addict. They grew up with an addict. So a lot of times addicts do, they don't take responsibility for their destructive behavior, and they blame others for their behavior. So the victim is forced to oftentimes remain silent or to accept the behavior. Therefore, a lot of pent up anger, resentment, and this leads to abusive behavior in the person who does the abuse. They basically, the addict blames others for their addictions instead of taking the instead of getting the help that they need and trying to get off of that, or should I say, get help with the addiction. When you're thinking about children, they may have seen their parents be addicted to drugs or alcohol, and then sometimes they may tend to be addicted themselves to drugs and alcohol. So an abuser that had addictive, had parents that may have been addictive to addicted to certain types of things may wind up being addicted themselves. However, again, there, that is a choice to say that I'm going to stay addicted. There is help, whether you're addicted to porn, whether you're addicted to alcohol, whether you're addicted to drugs, whether you're addicted to shopping, whatever the case may be, there is help available, but you have to make the choice. You have to make the choice to say that, you know what? I am not going to no longer allow myself to be addicted to certain things. So you have to be proactive in that choice. Number seven, they have control issues. They have control issues. People that are abusive, they like to be in charge. So they may have been in under the control of someone else. Therefore, they, in order to be on top, for was in their own minds, or be dominant in their own minds, they become the bully. They become the intimidator. They may not have had control over their own lives as a child or a teenager, growing up, or whatever the case may be. So therefore, they try to take the reins, and therefore they allow their authority to be misused and abused, and their leadership is often abusive rather than being a servant leader, leading out of humility. So they have control issues. Another thing is when you're dealing with someone that abuses, they don't understand boundaries. They don't understand boundaries. So they may have not had a lot of boundaries as a child, or they may have rebelled against those boundaries. And so therefore the abuser decides that they don't want to adhere to any type of boundaries. Maybe someone in their life abused their authority. So therefore they disrespect any type of authority, any type of boundary, any type of social norm that says that this is not okay. They don't understand that boundaries are necessary. So that is another reason why they may abuse. Another thing is they are afraid. They may have had someone in their life to use fear as a way to control them, to intimidate them, to justify their emotions. So therefore they are fearful, and they feel that power is the way to subdue their own fear because someone made them afraid. Again, this is never an excuse for anyone to abuse anyone. Just because someone did something that was not right to you does not give that person the right to do it to anyone else. But fear is often where a person may have felt that they had to fight their way out of a corner, then they may fight everyone else and use fear as a method of that type of intimidation when it comes to another person. Number 10, Another reason that people may abuse is because they lack empathy. We often talk about narcissists do not have empathy for others. They may imitate as if they do, but when we talk about narcissists, we talk about people that are only thinking about themselves. So therefore, they don't have empathy for how their victims feel. Some reasons that they may lack empathy is they may have had a trauma, head trauma. They may have a personality disorder, such as a psychopath or whatever. They may have had some environmental traumas, where they do not know how to express empathy. They may not have had empathy as a child, and so therefore they didn't know how to express it to other people. Again, does this give this person the excuse or the right to abuse? No. We're talking into understanding why people abuse, but it does not give anyone the right to abuse you. And just because someone has gone through this does not mean that you have to take abuse just because they were abused themselves. You don't want to have that, what we call Stockholm syndrome, where people or abusing you, you want to make sure that you do the opposite. All right, we're going to take a quick break and we'll be back in just a moment. Why does it hurt so bad? Why do I feel so sad? Thought I was over you, but I keep crying when I don't love you. So why does it hurt so bad? I thought I had let you go, so why does it hurt me so? I gotta get you out of my head. So bad, hurt so bad, babe.
Just when I think it's over, just when I think it's through, I find myself right back in love with you.
And that is Why Does It Hurt So Bad by the late Whitney Houston on the Waiting to Exhale soundtrack. Why does it hurt so bad? But let me just say this. Just because someone is hurting themselves, again, it does not give them the right to hurt you. Absolutely not. All right, so we're talking about reasons why people abuse. Number 11. They have a personality disorder. I think we talked about this earlier, where that they have a personality disorder, which means that just because they have one doesn't mean that they will abuse, but they may have more traits that contribute to that personality disorder. So therefore, they will have to be diagnosed by a licensed therapist in order to understand which type of personality disorder they have, because they may be unable to see that what their behavior is producing bad behavior or abusive behavior towards others. Again, this is not your fault. It does not mean just because somebody is a psychopath that you need to take abuse from that individual. Okay, they need to go get help to understand. You may be able to be instrumental in telling them what they do, but they have to acknowledge that there is something wrong. So therefore, you cannot change that individual. You can only maybe let them know that whatever they're doing is hurtful. But if someone's punching you, they know exactly what they're doing. So therefore, you don't have to explain anything. You just try to get the help that you need to keep yourself from being abused. Many people that are in therapy are in therapy not because of the one that's being the abuser that's saying, I need to get help to stop the abuse. It's often the victims of the abuse that are often in therapy. But the people who are doing the abuse also need therapy as well in order to prevent themselves and to acknowledge that their behavior is harming someone else. Another thing is they are exhausted. You know, you have people that might be at the end of the rope. They may be saying they may think that, you know what, they can't handle anything. So therefore, instead of going to get the help that they need from a therapist, they decide to be destructive. They destruct and harm other people. And so therefore, you don't want to be that person that's destructive or be around that person that is destroying you mentally, physically, spiritually, whatever the case may be. It is so important to make sure that you are not the recipient of someone else's abuse, no matter what the excuse may be, no matter what they have gone through, no matter what issues that may have brought the abuse up in them in order to make it easier for them to abuse someone else. It is important for you not to be a recipient of that. So therefore, you can empathize with what that person has gone through, but it doesn't mean that you have to be the victim of their abuse. Last but not least, one of the reasons that people abuse is because they are defensive. That this defense mechanism, it causes them to be in denial. It causes regression. It causes suppression of what they're really feeling. So therefore, they come out swinging and retaliate instead of going to get the help. They project their bad behavior onto other people. Again, a narcissist normally do not take responsibility for their behavior, but they will project it onto someone else. Is this a reason for someone to abuse someone else? No, it is not. There is, you know, you can understand, and let me just say this. You can understand and you can even empathize that people are going through various situations, and so therefore they may be more prone to going to abusing someone. You may understand the reason why they abuse, and this is what we're talking about today, is understanding why people abuse. But let me just say this, at the end of the day, it is a choice. Someone, you may have been abused as a child, but you have a choice to say, I am not going to do it to someone else. I'm going to go get the help that I need to not do it to someone else. You may have gone through some things as a child. Okay, before you have children, you say, you know what, I'm going to get the help I need. Or you feel like, hey, you know what, I'm going to repeat the same thing to somebody else, and then it will be better for you not to bring someone else into the world, knowing that you're going to do the exact same thing. You don't want to make make other victims. If you know that you have gone through something and you have not gotten the help that you need, I would encourage you to do so. But before you victimize someone else, it is best for you not to get involved in that relationship or even bring children in until you have gotten the help that you need in order to ensure that you don't damage someone else. If you are the victim of someone else's abuse and you're saying, you know what, I don't understand why. These are some of the reasons why people abuse. At the same time, we don't want you to have that Stockholm syndrome or that trauma bonding saying, well, oh, they went through this and they went through that, so therefore I have to allow them to abuse me. No, you do not. If you are in an abusive situation, especially I'm speaking to those who are going through physical violence right now, if you're in a domestic violence situation, you need to get out as safely as possible, as safely, and I always emphasize safely as possible. That means talk to someone you can trust. If you need to talk to the police, if you need to put things away so you can transition out of it. There are people dying every single day, especially women and children that are dying every day at the hand of their abusers, because they are in that situation. They may feel stuck. They may feel as if they don't have anyone who can help them. These people are not playing with you. Let me just say this. These people are not playing. They will kill you. And let me just say this. Do not allow any pastor, and I'm speaking as an evangelist, do not allow any pastor to tell you that you have to stay in an abusive situation. You may be of a religion that say, you know what, you can't get married again. Hey, it's better to be single in peace than to be getting a peace knocked upside your head. And I'm here to tell you today, if you might say, well, you know, will God forgive me if I separate? God will forgive you. God does not want you to be abused. Even if this means, you know, if there's different religions, believe different things, even if this means, you know what, I'm going to separate, you know, you might say, you know what, I believe that God doesn't want me to be remarried again because that's my beliefs or whatever. If I divorce this person or whatever case may be, the thing is, at least get separated from that abuser. And you might say, well, you know what, this person has changed and they promised me that they're not going to hit me anymore. Please pray about that situation, because many women have gone back into an abusive relationship only to get killed. Because once that person sees that you leave, they know that you can and will do it again. So therefore, they will try to take advantage of that situation, promise you the world, promise you the moon, and just to get you back into their good graces, only to kill you. Someone is dead today because they went back. Someone is dead today because they didn't leave. Someone is dead today because they didn't listen. Please, if you are being abused, if your children are being abused, talk to someone that you can trust so that they, you know, when you talk to a therapist, when you talk to someone in whether it's an attorney or someone in law enforcement, so that they can help you get the help that you need. No one deserves to be abused. And regardless of whatever the situation, whatever their background is, you can empathize with them, but you do not have to allow yourself to be the continuous victim of that individual who refused to go get the help that they need. And so therefore they're guilting you into staying because, oh, I went through this. Oh, I went through that. My mama, my daddy, my brother, my sister, whoever the case may be, may have abused them. That is not your issue when they refuse to go get the help that they need. So therefore you do not have to feel guilty because you decide that I'm going to safely remove myself or my children out of the situation. You deserve better. If someone is, and I'm going to, I believe that the next podcast, I'm going to talk about cheaters too, because you have those that are in abusive relationships when they come to cheating. And you're staying with this person and you know that they're cheating on you, bringing you back diseases and things of that nature. And one day they may bring you back something that there would be no cure for. And if that person refuses to honor that marriage, that's a form of abuse. And you do not have to be abused in any form by anybody. I'm here to tell you today, get the help that you need as safely as possible. All right, we are up out of here. I pray that today's podcast has been a blessing to you and that you will know your feelings do matter. This is Dr. K.L. Rich with Narc Abuse No More, helping you to admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse. Until next time.